A new report by the Centers for Disease Control reveals syphilis rates are soaring. Just a decade ago, doctors said the sexually transmitted disease was on the verge of elimination. So what is, please explain this. What is behind these numbers?
Well, really, it's actually pretty simple. It's men having sex with men who are behind these numbers.
Really?
I mean, you don't see this increase across all sorts of groups. Take a look at this number. Men having sex with men account for 62% of the syphilis cases in this country.
Really?
So that says something right there. And if you drill down even deeper, Black men ages 15 to 24, the syphilis rate among that. So men who are having sex with men are supposed to have annual screening for certain diseases, mm-hmm. but that doesn't always happen. So first, let's talk about the diseases. Syphilis, gonorrhea, chlamydia, and HIV. And one of these.
Oh, to screen for those things, because they're not going to be telling their doctor about that.
Right. I mean, some men are very open about it, but the men who aren't are really, in the end, doing themselves a disservice because they don't get screened for these diseases.
Exactly. So along with... this is clearly bad news. There's some good news about STDs as well coming from this study. Tell me
there
about this.
There are. Several diseases are stable. You don't see an increase. In fact, gonorrhea is at an all-time low, which is very interesting. And really, another one that's important is that syphilis among women is not going up, which is important not just for the women, but syphilis is a disease women can give to their babies. Mm-hmm. So it's good for moms and for babies that that rate is not going up.
So the takeaway, I mean, it's the same thing that we say all the time. You have to be completely transparent with your doctor.
Right. Be transparent. And also, in case your doctor isn't aware, you should be aware of what you, given your sexual habits, need to be screened for on a regular basis.
Exactly. Oh, my gosh. All right. Elizabeth
Thanks.
Cohn, thanks so much. So coming up, three simple ways to help dig yourself out of $13,000 worth of debt. We've got the tips on the other side. That was, of course, the Emmy Award-winning Showtime series Dexter, about a vigilante serial killer that also works as a blood splatter expert. Today's Big Eye segment is all about new technology that would have Dexter shaking in his boots. When blood is spilled, most criminals try to wash it away. Well, it actually doesn't completely wash away. And to hear to tell us about a new blood-stained camera of all things, University of South Carolina professor Stephen Morgan. Thank you so much for joining me, Mr. Morgan. Tell me, what's this all about? What does this camera offer that the technology and the chemicals that are available today do not?
Well,
how does the camera actually work? Clearly, this is not your typical camera that you're just going around taking pictures of blood stains, but how does the technology actually work? The advantage of this technology is that you're not actually touching or interacting with the blood stain. It's almost in its purest form, which has to be an asset when you're looking at a crime scene.
Of blood, an investigator can go directly to that spot and take it.
Commercially available now, or where are you in the process? Stephen Morgan, this is fascinating stuff. Thanks so much for joining me today.
Thank you.
All right. Let's take a look at some of the other top stories that are developing right now. The jury handed down a guilty verdict in Chandra Levy's murder trial today. Ingmar Gwandike faces life without parole. He's already doing time for attacks on two other women. Levy was a 24-year-old Washington intern who disappeared on a jog in May 2001. Her body wasn't found for more than a year. And police are investigating the death of a young boy at the Staples Center in Los Angeles. He fell 50 feet from a luxury suite shortly after a Lakers basketball game. Just horrible. The boy was 2 or 3 years old, and police have not revealed his name or the circumstances leading to that fall. If you suffered losses in the BP Gulf Coast oil disaster, you have until Wednesday to file a request for compensation. BP, you'll remember this, set aside $20 billion in a special fund. So far, about $2 billion has been paid to settle 125,000 claims. Those who reject settlements can then take their chances and take their case to court. And a new FBI report says more than 6,600 hate crimes were committed across the country last year. Almost half were motivated by race. Most of the rest were motivated by religion or sexual orientation. The FBI says 62% of the offenders were white, while 19% were black. So did you hear what former First Lady Barbara Bush had to say about Sarah Palin? It definitely turned heads and raised a couple eyebrows. Our political ticker is just ahead.